Hey everybody out there, glad you could join me for another video. In this one, I'm going to be giving you my review of Blade 2, and you'll be happy to know that finally I think I watched a Blade movie that held up over the years. It started out a little cringy with the Wesley Snipes voiceover, but it definitely proves that it is the best out of the trilogy. As I'm sure you guys know by now, Blade is a Marvel superhero who is half human, half vampire, with all of their strengths and none of their weaknesses except one, and that's the thirst. Fairly early on in the movie, we find out that Whistler is not dead like we thought, but instead the vampires took him, and he too became a vampire, and now Blade is hunting him down. To cure him if he can, and to kill him if he has to. After Blade rescues Whistler from the vampire stronghold, and in fact is able to cure him, we find out that there is a bigger threat to humanity than vampires. It's actually a new breed of vampires called the Reapers. And if they don't do something about it, this new breed of super vampires could possibly take over the world in a few short years. So Blade reluctantly has to team up with a group of vampires who've been specifically trained to hunt and destroy him. So now that they have to work with him, you can imagine some of the tension and interaction that happens. And it's really funny. I think that Wesley Snipes and Ron Perlman have great chemistry together. Blade 2 is absolutely awesome. After all these years, I feel like it's the one out of the three that's held up. Special effects-wise, story-wise, and the acting is just incredible. No one is ever going to be able to take away that some of the fight scenes in the first movie were pretty damn badass. But I personally think that this film, story-wise, is worlds above the other two. Now, this film is directed by Del Toro, and I think it's his first comic book adaptation film because he did go on to do the Hellboy movies. That is to say, Hellboy 1 and 2. He didn't have anything to do with the remake to Hellboy, which I really enjoyed, but I know a lot of other people didn't. Maybe I can slip a review in here before Halloween for it. But my point in bringing Del Toro up is if you ever watch the TV show The Strain, which I believe is based on a book that he wrote, it's got a lot of similarities to Blade 2, and I think this was his chance to delve into that world of vampires and this idea of a virus. So if you're interested, you might want to go ahead and check out The Strain. Now back to my review of Blade 2. So this movie is really fun from start to finish. It's really, really bloody. And if you're squeamish and you haven't seen Blade 2 yet, be prepared because there is an autopsy scene in it. After watching this movie again, it's tough for me to picture anybody else in the Blade role other than Wesley Snipes, because he is completely badass in this movie, and I think Marvel is going to be hard-pressed getting Mahershala Ali to anywhere close to Wesley Snipes status. I just look at him, and I don't get that same feeling of intimidation as I do at looking at Wesley Snipes as Blade. And that's not to say I couldn't be totally wrong. I may walk out of the Marvel Blade movie and think, wow, that was the best Blade ever. But right now, it's hard for me to picture. I had forgotten that Norman Reedus was in this movie, and he plays Scud, the replacement Whistler. And I absolutely love his character. I thought he did a really good job. And my only complaint is that Whistler wasn't the one that got to blow him up. I mean, come on, you had him dogging on Whistler the whole movie and you couldn't give him a little payback? At least let him throat punch him or something. Ron Perlman shows up in the movie and he plays an asshole fairly well. But even when he's playing an asshole, the dude's an amazing actor, and he would go on to play Hellboy. Donnie Yen's in here, and I had forgotten that as well. Not a big part, but it was still cool to see him in an American movie. You know what I just realized that this movie did? It is the only movie, as far as I'm concerned, to give us a Marvel villain where you can understand his motivation, but at the same time, you're not rooting for him to win. If that makes sense. Basically, it's me saying, hey Marvel, I'm tired of villains that I can feel bad for. Give me a villain I can really hate, and I'll be happy. Just one time, please. A villain I can hate. And I'm afraid that this movie is the one and only time I'm going to get that in my lifetime out of Marvel. At least while Disney owns him, and that'll probably be forever. Anyways, guys, this is the end of my review, and giving Blade 2 a rating between 1 and 10, I'm going to go with a solid 7. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe. Let me know what you thought of the audio, and I will see you all in my next one. Bye.